This is the President speaking. Meine Damen und Herren, herzlich willkommen zurück zur dritten Folge This is the President bei Let's Splinter. Ihr habt sehr ordentlich eingeschaltet, was mich wirklich freut. Insofern wünsche ich euch viel Spaß bei der neuen Folge. Wir haben eine Menge zu tun und steigen sofort ein. Wir haben ein Leck zu stopfen. How to fix a leak. Your communications director has a plan for dealing with the leak. Alta Randor ist unsere Communications Directorin, wie man so schön sagt. Hey, what the hell is going on? Not only has some moron leaked details on your first executive order, but now the imbeciles are saying that you're a bioterrorist. Wie antworten wir hierauf? But I only want to save lives, not destroy them. Wie gesagt, kommen wir gleich zu What are those idiots talking about this time? Oder don't worry about it, they'll make a bunch of noise and then forget all about it. Das ist keine gute Variante. Wir sollten die Menge nicht reden lassen. Die Frage ist, ob wir gnadenlos durchziehen, dass wir ehrenwerte Absichten haben. Und wir versuchen es an der Stelle einfach mal. Alter sagt, the press has already decided that the vaccine is just a cover for monstrous experiments. Na super. I guess there's no point mentioning that you yourself added fuel to the fire, admitting that you really are working on an executive order like that. Ja gut, also das Problem ist, dass die Presse aus unserem Ziel, Krebs zu besiegen, tatsächlich eine Geschichte macht, dass wir irgendwelche Experimente an oder mit der Bevölkerung durchführen möchten. Wir befinden uns im 21. Jahrhundert einer Pandemie und ich erkenne Parallelen. What, a cure for cancer isn't interesting enough anymore? What's the problem? I only told the truth or they finally got me. Wir gehen auf die Wahrheit. In other words, we need a surefire plan for how we're responding to this nonsense. Das stimmt. It sounds to me like you already have a plan ready to go. Oder I have an idea how we can take them down. Ja, wir lassen es unserer Kommunikationsdirektorin, wie wir dagegen vorgehen wollen. Can't fool you, cowboy. Here's how it works. Let's say that yesterday I drank a little, got behind the wheel and dent the little pillar in the parking lot. I don't want to pay for it, so I start a rumor that I smashed into several expensive cars in the parking lot. The security guard hears about this, runs around in horror, checking all the expensive cars up and down. And what does he see? All the cars safe and sound. So the guard sighs in relief and goes back to his booth. Aus irgendeinem Grund habe ich gerade ein Déjà-vu. Ich weiß allerdings nicht woher. Falls ihr es wisst oder wisst, woher es kommen könnte, kurzer Kommentar. Aber irgendwas war auch in der Hinsicht schon mal. War das in diesem Safe-Game? And about that dented pillar, he's already forgotten all about in the bustle. You see what I'm getting at? You mean we'll spread even crazier rumors than the ones they are already writing about me? Oder how do you know this idea will work? Wir fragen sie, wie das Ganze funktionieren soll. Because the cops never caught me. Okay, überzeugend. Seriously, those journalists will pick up any garbage they stumble across and will be standing ready to refute their nonsense. So let's make up a good rumor. It needs to be something that captures people's imagination and is difficult to verify. Imagine that you're coming up with a backstory for a mysterious villain in a superhero movie, but you can't go fully into wild fiction. How do you intrigue people? Boah, sind das viele Antwortmöglichkeiten, ihr entschuldigt, aber ich lese die einmal komplett vor. In fact, I'm not an ordinary person, but a genetic engineering product born in a test tube. When I was a teenager, I accidentally found out that I was adopted. Ever since then, I've been angry with the whole world. Ooh, interessant. I starred in a popular reality show as a scientist, and after that I performed plastic surgery on myself so that no one would recognize me. Oder I'm a crazy professor who spends every night in a secret underground lab. Ich mag die Ironie in den Antwortmöglichkeiten. Das Spiel könnte tatsächlich ziemlich witzig werden, wenn sie es gut machen. Ich entscheide mich für When I was a teenager, I accidentally found out that I was adopted. Ever since then, I've been angry with the whole world. Kleine Paranoia. I think I've heard that one before, but it works, and we can easily refute it with a single official document. Now we need to give you a superpower, but one that people can easily believe in. What could it be? Ooh, Superkräfte aussuchen. Sensationell. I manipulate public opinion. I can read other people's minds. Das würde die Leute zum Durchdrehen bringen, wenn ich behaupte, ich könnte anderer Leute Gedächtnis oder Gedanken lesen. After a long and painful training, I've become a perfect liar. I can beat any polygraph. Oder nevertheless, I never lose money. It's like it's always climbing into my pocket. I manipulate public opinion. The fact that you became president certainly proves that, after all, millions voted for you. Das ist korrekt, Alter. And finally, like in any story, the hero needs a believable motive. Remember, we've got to be able to refute it. So tell me, what are you trying to achieve? I want to take revenge on my supervisor who ridiculed my graduate work in bioengineering. I want to design the perfect cyborg soldier. That's crazy. I want to infect the planet with a virus that will subordinate every person to my will. Auf keinen Fall. Or I want to develop a vaccine against a rare disease that I've contracted. Boah, mir gefällt relativ wenig. Aber wir gehen auf die Revanche gegen den Supervisor. That will do. If the journalists did their jobs properly, they'd figure out that you only have an MBA. By the way, are you aware that you'll only be the second president of the USA with that diploma? Großartig. When I was a teenager, I accidentally found out that I was adopted. Ever since then, I've been angry with the whole world. I manipulate public opinion. I want to take revenge on my supervisor who ridiculed my graduate work in bioengineering. Alright, this rumor is going to be perfect. Ich zweifle noch ein wenig, aber we refute it and you're golden. Okay. Wenn das mal erfolgreich gewesen sein soll, Alter, arbeite. New team member. Buckle up, Cowboy. It's time we gave those hyenas a taste of their own medicine. Unsere Communications Directorin, Alter Randor. Herzlich willkommen im Team. Herzlich willkommen bei Let's Splinter. Und Ellie kann ihren Mund nicht halten. If Alter says we should spread stupid rumor, then that's what we'll do. She earned our trust during the campaign. Just as much as Alvaro, Clint and Ollie. And I'm not just saying that because she's a friend. Okay, Alter ist also durchaus positiv bewertet. Philanthropist Ava Sarjo, Mr. President-elect. As you surely know, every self-respecting ruler has his own charity. Your wife asked me to register a foundation called Hands of Good. It will come in handy if you ever want to do a couple of good deeds or more. The IRS isn't going to look too closely at the Hands of Good, so you can dispose of the fund's money as you see fit. Give everything to orphans or to civil servants if you wish, or pay your employees' salary. It's humanitarian aid either way. The people trust you, and I have no doubt that these expenses, whatever they are, will always benefit our country. Okay, das war ziemlich viel Text. Wir könnten gute Dinge tun, wir können es aber auch sein lassen. Ava Sarto hat sich einfach mal zu Wort gemeldet. Ansonsten passiert nicht so viel. Write a text of Amendment 28 that you will present to the congressman during negotiations. Wir sollten uns hieran begeben, und zwar zügigst. Darling, I'm already overwhelmed with the O. Send a suitable employee on the mission. Keep in mind that they will not return until next month. Okay, was sagt Ellie? Darling, I'm already overwhelmed with the amendment and there's a lot of work to be done. We need a final text as soon as possible. When we get Noah on board, he'll have to present something to the congressman. Can you lend me an employee from headquarters to help out at least a little? Okay, wir machen das also nicht selbst, sondern schicken jemanden dafür. Puh. Tendenz Alter. Writing press releases and speeches. Die Frage ist, ob Alter uns dann an irgendeiner Stelle fehlt. Wir schicken Alter, um das Ganze abzufassen. Das würde in meinen Augen Sinn ergeben. Damit ist sie erstmal einen Monat weg. Und wir können weitermachen. Fill the remaining positions in the administration. Ja, wunderbar. Auch hier müssen wir nur zuteilen. Mr. President, unser HR Manager meldet sich. Tina Y. You personally make the decision on key appointments in administration, but beyond that, we need to hire an army of clerks to handle day-to-day business of government. I understand that you can't approve every candidate, you have better things to do, but maybe you could send someone from your team to supervise the process. Wir brauchen noch ein wenig was für unser Team und lassen das entscheiden. Clint wäre Tendenz. Ja, wir schicken Clint. Clint hat den Vorteil, Connections from the former Clients, also von den früheren Klienten zu haben. Insofern hat er ein gutes Netzwerk und könnte richtige Personen auswählen. Das wirkt mir hier erstmal grundsätzlich solide. Und so gehen unsere Mitarbeiter schon auf Tour. Ja, herzlichen Glückwunsch. Compose the first executive order. Prepare the first document you will sign on inauguration day. Also am Tag der Ernennung. Antonio Estaba meldet sich. Buddy, please appoint one of your team members to be in charge of drafting the first executive order to develop a cancer vaccine. It's always like that. Nothing gets off the ground until you put someone in charge. It was just like that with my birthday party. Until I hinted to Ellie that I hoped it would be perfectly planned, the party wasn't even on our schedule. Alvaro können wir dafür natürlich nicht einsetzen. Die Frage ist, müssen wir das jetzt machen? Ich kann hier nicht weiter an der Stelle. Ja, doch. Wir müssen zuteilen. Und dann nehmen wir Olli. Das gefällt mir eigentlich gar nicht so richtig. Aber was haben wir für Wahlen? Also, ab dafür. You dealt with everything that was urgent and now we can move to the next month. Okay, wir haben also den November abgeschlossen und können voranschreiten und gucken, was passiert an so einem Monatswechsel. Lame Duck gab uns Minus, ihr habt es in der letzten Folge gesehen. Und die Victory Speech aus Folge 1 war unser großer Kickoff. Insofern sind wir insgesamt etwas hochgegangen in unserem Rating und stehen momentan bei, ja, ist es dann 48,6? Ich glaube schon. Und bitteschön, herzlich willkommen im Dezember 2020. Draft the Amendment. Your subordinate is back. Okay, das war dann wirklich kein langer Verlust. Alter ist wieder da. Honey, Alter has finished with the draft and has an abstract for you that covers the main points. Amendment 28 to the United States Constitution. No president from the United States shall be prosecuted after their term in office is over for the decisions made before the term was over. Soweit der Zusatzartikel 28. Das ist das Teil, das wir durchbekommen müssen. Continue. Und natürlich ist Clint wieder da. Mr. President, Clint has filled the administration with lawyers of the highest caliber, just like him. He says he went through all his contacts to do so. I assure you we've assembled the most competent people we could possibly afford. Plus 1,5% hat uns das gegeben. Das war wohl eine gute Wahl. Wir steigen auf 50,1. Und auch Olli ist wieder zurück. Buddy, Ollie never drafted an executive order before, so this one for developing the vaccine had him stumped at first. Ja, ich ahnte, dass das nicht so eine gute Wahl ist. Also im Prinzip war er damit offenkundig mega überfordert. But he found a solution. He got the text of thousands of executive orders from the Library of Congress and fed them into a neural network. Then he entered the title and you picked and presto, he got the whole thing in an instant. Ja, großartig. Olli hat improvisiert. At first I thought it was a joke, but this executive order is more readable than what usually comes from the crooks in Congress. Olli has prepared a summary of the decree for you. Check out what he's come up with. Despite progress in the early detection and treatment of cancer, thousands of Americans die every year from its many different forms. You will assemble the best scientists and fund the creation of a great laboratory that will finally discover a universal cancer vaccine. You will pay for this laboratory from the budget. Klingt doch super. Ich weiß gar nicht, was ihr habt. Olli war die perfekte Wahl. Ja, also ich hätte gerne Alter für beides genommen. Das ist natürlich die Realität dahinter, aber Daumen hoch, Olli. Current goal, pay 7 million bucks to know the lobbyist. Okay, wir haben keinen einzigen Cent dazu bekommen. In the media. What are the president-elect supporters saying? Will life in America be better now that he's taking revenge on his research advisor who neglected his talent in bioengineering? Joe Lynn, right in the center. Und Justice C, Johanna Rizzuto schreibt, the country still hasn't recovered from the shock of the presidential elections. Rumor has it in establishment circles that President Feast won't be giving up so easily and is planning both formal procedures and informal maneuvers to remain in the White House for as long as possible. Also der aktuelle Präsident möchte nicht abhauen. Und das ist so eine Sache, hier schwingt so ein bisschen mit. Hier steht ja der Shock of the Presidential Elections. Ich gehe ja immer noch davon aus, dass ich der Gute bin. Aber ich glaube, das Spiel sagt das von vornherein exakt nicht. Die sagen, ich bin der Arsch. Und Conrad Glover schreibt bei Twitter: Tell you what, brother, that new president, that's Coyote, I know him. I used to go on runs for him back in the 90s. I figured one of the competition took him down by now, but look, he's been rising high, oh shit, and Clint works for him too. Ein ziemlich beliebter Tweet von Conrad Glover, der uns durchaus zu schaffen machen könnte. Wir bekommen also so ein bisschen hier mit, was die Presse und auch das Internet so über uns schreibt, und es sieht nicht allzu gut aus. David Cedar, Prime Minister of Israel. Oh. Greetings, Mr. President-elect. I have come to New York on an unannounced visit to handle a personal matter. I'm sure you're extremely busy right now, but if you could give me some time, I would be most grateful to meet you in person. Der Prime Minister von Israel besucht zufällig New York und wir sollten Zeit für ihn haben. Alter sagt, so how about giving those journalists a public flogging? We have all the documents we need to expose the rumors as fabrications. The main thing is to keep calm and hammer the facts. Deny everything that they are trying to hang on you. Once journalists realize that they can't provoke you, they'll calm down. An unexpected visit aus Israel und fabricated rumor. Das sind die Dinge, die nun anstehen. Und ich würde vorschlagen, oh Moment, you received the first document you can sign. All signable documents are stored in a separate lab. Okay, wir können also Dinge unterzeichnen. You can start signing documents as soon as you are inaugurated, but you can use the time before you become president to lobby for your first executive order. Lobbying costs money, but if you hype up a document before you sign it, it will give you a bigger ratings bump. Okay, wir können also, obwohl wir das Ding noch nicht unterzeichnen, denn das geht erst ab der... ab Inauguration Day, ihr wisst schon, wovon ich spreche, wir können das Ganze letzten Endes dann ein wenig abhypen durch Lobbyarbeit. Kostet Geld, gibt aber die Ratings natürlich massiv nach oben. Lobbying takes a month, each document can be lobbied twice for an even bigger rating boost. First Executive Order, Fighting Cancer, document will be lobbied to level 2. 200.000, um das Ganze von 1% auf 9% zu heben, und das ist nun mal wirklich erheblich. Wir lobbyieren. Sehr gut. Lobbying in process für einen Monat, sodass wir 9% plus haben. Wir könnten es dann auf Level 3 hieven, kostet uns dann das 4,5-fache, wenn ich es gerade richtig, 4,5-fache, und steigert dann nochmal 5,6 Prozentpunkte. Nicht mehr so viel wie bei den ersten 200.000. Wir müssen also ein bisschen abwägen, ob an der Stelle dann mehr Geld reinfließen soll, um die paar Prozentpunkte noch rauszuholen. Wir haben noch Amendment 28 und können dort allerdings keine Lobbyarbeit betreiben. Okay, wir gehen hier also raus. Speed up window and text animations, hold down the right mouse button. Okay, haben wir registriert. Wir begrüßen den Prime Minister von Israel und gucken, was er will. Ich habe so ein bisschen die Vermutung, nichts Gutes. Aber treffen wir uns mit ihm. Good evening, Mr. President-elect. Please take a seat. Warum ist der outgoing President da? Mr. Cedar, are we not having a private meeting? Feast, what are you doing here? Ich wende mich an Mr. Cedar. My friend, I'll let you in on a little secret. This is my meeting. David flew in at my request, but we decided to invite you so you won't blow a fuse. Super. Feast hat das Ganze organisiert. Ach, wie ätzend. Oh, come now, my old friend. Why do you rush to attack? Oh, David Cedar. Sagt Mr. President-elect, please excuse him. Drew is a great man. He just hasn't yet come to his senses after his recent defeat. Okay, ist das geschauspielert? Drew sagt, seriously, David, he started it first. I took him in as a friend and in return all he did was spit in my face. Drew ist echt nicht begeistert von mir. Get over yourself, Feast. You only summoned the Prime Minister here so you could cry on his shoulder. Oder aber, so now you're telling your foreign friends never to do business with me again. Oder aber, you can't fool me. You set me up at that press conference. Beziehen wir uns nochmal auf die Pressekonferenz. Oder, ich will eigentlich gar nicht groß drauf eingehen. So now you're telling your foreign friends never to do business with me again. Why should I tell them anything? They have their own intelligence services. They already know everything they want you want to know you about. Den habe ich ein bisschen verdreht, den Satz. Ihr entschuldigt. I've already said it, but I'll say it again. Do you think that David and I are some heartless bastards who sit around drinking bourbon while ordinary people are suffering in poverty? We are not drinking for fun, but out of grief. Our careers have been a series of missed opportunities. You sure don't ever change. You never admit your mistakes. Oder aber, we didn't. Why didn't you publicly apologize? That would have earned you a few more votes, maybe enough to carry the election. I don't care about those damn votes, but I am delighted that you won, my friend. Although some of the comments that you and your vice president made surely swung a few votes back my way. You continue making a spectacle of yourself. This urge to pick fights with other countries, where is this coming from? Relax. Okay, also ist ein bisschen zwiegespalten. I called you for one simple reason. You see, there is one powerful person who refuses to admit your victory. Worum geht's? Wait, did you really throw the election on purpose? He's in prison, so he's no threat to me. Schaltet mal bitte auf Folge 1 zurück und schaut euch nochmal das Intro an. Who is that person? Ja gut, das muss ich natürlich auch noch herausfinden. Aber ich weiß natürlich, um wen es geht, aber will ich herausfinden, wer es ist? Oder weiß ich es schon und sage, er ist keine Gefahr? Ich will mehr über die Person wissen. Neugierde macht sich breit. Stop it. You know who I'm talking about. Ja, ich weiß, aber wer ist es denn? You've been shitting on Wister and he wants to get his hands on you. Right now he's got a whole army of Secret Service agents guarding you. That's why he's looking for any lead to keep you out of the White House. And I assure you, even if you do make it there, this will not make your life any safer. Things might get even worse. I will become president and take him down myself. Oder, so what is the planning to do? Hier zündelt sich gerade ein kleiner Komplott, meine Damen und Herren. Worum soll es gehen? I wouldn't want to spoil the surprises of your first days in office. You'll see soon enough. Na super. David, how might I best help our new friend out of his trouble without myself raising any eyebrows? David sagt, well, dude, that's quite the task. I can only share my experiences. I personally orchestrate the leaks that come from my administration. I say what I will do first, second and third, and in the end, I do the fourth instead. Thus, I remain unpredictable to my opponents and smoke out the traitors. Okay, wir sollen also ein wenig distracten. Well, you're quite the asshole. I myself always keep everything under lock and key, the kind of lock that no one can pick. But our dear friend here doesn't know that art. It would seem his lock has already been picked. I'm not going to lie to anyone, especially not my own people. Oder, so what do you expect me to do with all this? Wir lügen nicht. Wir haben immer noch gute Absichten. Ich verweise auf vorangegangene Unterhaltungen. But it's your people that are lying to you. I'm being honest, I wasn't behind your little leak. Let's say this. So long as our interests remain intertwined, I will help you. You've already received news from a person who is not publicly connected with me, so no one will learn that I'm helping you. Publicly, I will continue to shake my fist at you, and you must likewise continue your public criticism of me. Keep telling the world what a bastard I am. Don't worry, it's like sweet music to me, and no one will suspect our collusion. Das heißt, wir sollen weiterhin so tun, als könnten Feast und wir uns gar nicht ab. Und im Hintergrund versuchen wir, die Interessen gemeinsam zu verfolgen. Puh, anstrengend. Feast, do you really think I'm going to trust you? What are you talking about? I hope you're not lying this time. Boah. Frage ist, wenn ich jetzt ihn frage, ob ich ihm wirklich glauben würde, zerschlägt sich dieser Plan? Wir lassen es uns noch ein wenig genauer erklären. My apologies, but I can't say no more. It's simply too dangerous. Soon you will understand what I mean. And now I'm sorry, but I must be alone with David. He's the only one who can help me out of the pile of shit I find myself in. I have but one simple wish. A quiet retirement. Please try to understand, my friend, and if possible, don't discuss our conversation with anyone. Although, who would believe you if you did? Wahre Geschichte. Mr. President-elect again. Please forgive me. It's a pity that we had to meet under such circumstances, but I simply couldn't refuse to use request. I promise, next time we meet it, will be just the two of us. Ja, das will ich auch hoffen, David. Mein Gott. Israel macht Trouble, und zwar im wahrsten Sinne des Wortes. Inklusive Feast. Faithless Electors, ein new Event. Attorney Ostaba meldet sich. Buddy, I decided to bring back the good old days and found out something most unpleasant. We are being spied upon, and no, we are not talking about Secret Service and agents. Some shady characters are watching every step we take. According to my old contacts in the FBI, they refer directly to Warren Munger, head of National Intelligence. Here's a recording I made the other day, abiding by all rules of secrecy. As soon as I gather more evidence of illegal surveillance, we'll counterattack them together. Special Services Tape. The private conversations of agents. When their superiors hear this, a lot of heads will roll. Tapes like these are not easy to obtain and will fetch a lot of money on the open market. Wir werden verfolgt. Soweit, so klar. Das dürfte mittlerweile auch dem, naja, sage ich mal, Blindesten aufgefallen sein. Antonio Stava sagt: Buddy, the election campaign has been really stressful for us. Everyone's on edge and about to lose their tempers. Alter is bullying Alvaro around. Even Clint starts tapping on the table whenever anyone talks to him. But of course, it's me who suffers the most, or Armer Antonio. You know how sensitive I am. Luckily, an old colleague buddy of mine, the coolest psychologist ever, is in DC. Right now, he's not cheap, but why don't we call him in to help? He'll have everything sorted out in 10 minutes. Otherwise, I'll start to lose my mind. 10.000 für was Antonio meint, was uns sofort helfen würde. Machen wir Reuben Shapiro, Chairman and Pharmasuits. Mr. President, our corporation has created the Jupiter N vaccine. I believe that one day it will eradicate the flu. But the anti-vaccine lobby has been on the rise. Now they're calling us greedy baby killers. To increase public trust in pharmasuits, we filmed the vaccination movie stars, influencers, and politicians. President Feast, for example, has already participated. Would you like to be a part of this campaign? One shot in the shoulder, and we donate 150.000 to your charity account. Wie könnte ich dazu Nein sagen, wenn ich einen Impfstoff gegen Krebs durchbekommen möchte? 150.000 für den Charity-Account ist außerdem eine gute Sache und wir torpedieren, indem wir eine kurze Ladung bekommen. You received your first item. To use it, go to the Items tab. Was haben wir bekommen? You can use items to earn ratings, boosts or other bonuses. You can also sell items to Noah. He's always happy to buy compromising evidence and the like, and he knows how to make it pay well. To get new items, go on missions and complete assignments. Wir haben ein Special Services Tape und können es für 900.000 vertickern. Nicht schlecht. Darling, sagt Ellie, I suggest you hold on to blackmail materials unless you urgently need more money to approval rating. There's no need to sell it to Nora right away. It may come in handy when dealing with influential people. Ellie rät uns also dazu, diese Gegenstände nur mit Bedacht zu verkaufen. Und genau das werden wir tun. Wir sind noch 1,79 Millionen Dollar schwer, haben ein Rating von 50,1, leicht angestiegen wieder und haben so einige Personen kennengelernt, inklusive dem israelischen Prime Minister. Meine Damen und Herren, das war die dritte Folge von This is the President und so langsam beginnt es schon knifflig zu werden. Insofern möchte ich hoffen, dass es ein wenig entspannter wird, aber ich glaube nicht dran. Wenn ihr mir ein Abo dalassen würdet und in der nächsten Folge wieder einschaltet, würde ich mich sehr darüber freuen. Bis dahin sage ich, macht es gut und bis zum nächsten Mal bei This is the President und Let's Splinter. Macht's gut. Ciao, ciao.